Jean-Luc Picard is back.
If you're a fan of Star Trek, and why wouldn't you be, you clicked on this video, you might have good reason to be concerned that the new Picard TV show will be yet further descent into the grim, dark Trek that we've seen so far in that god-awful Discovery show. This is where all the hope of Roddenberry's original vision has been assimilated into the unstoppable forces of woke.
Your culture will adapt to service us. Resistance is futile.
Imagine being upset that Star Trek is political. Yes, Star Trek has always been political. Some fundamental aspects of the premise are political. I'll even admit it's very easy to interpret it as progressive. But anyone who's familiar with more than the most basic Star Trek trivia understands that it's not really fair to equate the politics of the show with the partisan affairs of our time. The world of Star Trek is post-scarcity, meaning it doesn't matter where you sit on the societal hierarchy. No one's sleeping rough, no one's going hungry. You can't just shoehorn a situation like that into an analogy of today's political climate. That gulf is too wide. The politics of Star Trek are supposed to be more subtle than that. They're in the interactions between the different characters and alien races, their values, their principles, their ethics, and their standards. Star Trek is at its very best when it's getting right down to fundamentals, not when it's getting its hands dirty, picking at the weeds of red versus blue. Look, I get it. Whatever Picard turns out to be, this won't be the first time he's come face to face with what he sees as a political climate descending into fascism. Drumhead is one of my favourite episodes of all time. It's where Picard is forced to deal with an enemy who tries to subvert Federation law for her own personal megalomania. In that episode, a Klingon spy is captured, and hey, doesn't this sound familiar?
You accuse me because I am Klingon!
Anyway, Starfleet assigns a retired admiral to the Enterprise to work with Picard and investigate the matter when an explosion follows the Klingon spy's capture. This very quickly turns into a witch hunt, with the principles of presumption of innocence, right to privacy, freedom of association, thrown quickly aside in the name of security. And where no evidence of a crime can be found, and in fact, evidence of the opposite is discovered, conspiracy theories, circumstantial evidence, and hearsay are elevated to the level of unquestionable fact. Very quickly, the accusers become the accused, and when the Admiral becomes unhinged in her pursuit, Picard, as he always is there to throw her own hypocrisy back in her face.
If for no other purpose than to determine Tarsus's innocence.
Now please, let me remind you, he is innocent until he is proved guilty.
I'm deeply concerned about what is happening here.
It began when we apprehended a spy, a man who admitted his guilt and who will answer for his crime. But the hunt didn't end there. Another man, Mr. Simon Tarsis, was brought to trial, and it was a trial, no matter what others choose to call it. A trial based on insinuation and innuendo. Nothing substantive offered against Mr. Tarsis, much less proven.
You know, there are some words I've known since I was a schoolboy. With the first link, the chain is forged. The first speech censured, the first thought forbidden, the first freedom denied, chains us all irrevocably. Those words were uttered by Judge Aaron Satie as wisdom and warning. First time any man's freedom is trodden on, we're all damaged.
The episode ends with one of Picard's wisest monologues to ever appear in all of The Next Generation.
You think we've come so far? Torture of
Heretics, burning of witches, all ancient history. Then, before you can blink an eye, suddenly it threatens to start all over again.
I believed her. I helped her. I did not see what she was.
Mr. Worf, villains who twirl their mustaches are easy to spot. Those who clothe themselves in good deeds are well camouflaged.
I think, after yesterday, people will not be so ready to trust her.
Maybe. But she, or someone like her, will always be with us, waiting for the right climate in which to flourish, spreading fear in the name of righteousness. Vigilance, Mr. Worf. That is the price we have to continually pay.
So what's the problem? They tackled politics back then, why can't they do it now? The difference is, the way they handled politics in 1991 and how we all know it's going to be handled now. When this episode first aired, it would have been very easy to interpret it as commentary on the overreach of McCarthyism. Just as easy as it is now to interpret this episode 30 years after it aired as a rebuke of today's far-left progressives and their attempt to censor and destroy anyone who gets between them and their utopian ideal of social justice. Point is, Star Trek focused on principles, not partisan politics, and that made it timeless. In another 20 years, who knows who this episode will strike a chord with? Whoever it is, one thing we can be sure of is that the wisdom contained in this episode will be as valuable then as it is now, just as it was when it was made. How relevant is an anti-Trump, anti-Brexit show going to be in the decades to come? What will it have to teach who's ever watching it then? So when people like me say, keep your politics out of my entertainment, we don't mean don't ever touch on anything political. What we mean is, we don't want political activists hijacking what used to be insightful, thought-provoking storytelling just so they can shit out uninspired partisan propaganda and then call us bigots when we refuse to swallow it. And even though that goes for propaganda from any spot on the political compass, we all know which political ideology is going to be propagandized in a TV show made in current year. So what do you think? Will Picard go the way of so many shows before it? Discovery. Doctor Who. Or will it step up and once again give us a Star Trek show that's timeless and insightful, that doesn't start off by alienating anyone who doesn't identify as far left, which, depending on how you count it, could be as much as 90% of the general population?
It's a bold strategy, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for them.
If you'd like to see more content like this, hit subscribe, give us a like, leave your comments below. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.